Welcome back to the studio, everybody. My name is Jim, and this is a Pugmill. Today, I'll explain to you what it is, how it works, and how to change the clay that's inside. So if you're curious, get ready.
A Pugmill is a machine that can mix drier and softer clays together, or mix clay from scratch. Underneath the black panel, you have your motor housing and hub. This is your mixing chamber, also referred to as a hopper. Then you have your reduction nozzle. Clay gets forced through here and packed into cylinders on the way out. I'm changing to a new clay for this Pugmill, so I have to remove all the old clay first and clean it out before I put the new clay in. I recommend WD-40 if you're taking this apart, especially if it's the first time. I spray the four bolts on the first half and there's six on the back half. Here I'm using an adjustable wrench and a ratchet with a 9/16 socket. You can use two adjustable wrenches too, it just takes longer. Make sure you keep track of the nuts and bolts. Once the four bolts are removed, the only thing keeping these two things together is the clay packed inside. Use a wire tool to separate the two pieces and be careful, it's heavy. Here's a little preview of the auger inside. Next, remove the other six bolts on the back half of the reduction nozzle, starting with the bottom first. I used a scraper and then a screwdriver to slowly and gently pry the nozzle away from the mixing chamber. When it starts to detach, slowly wiggle and pull the second half of the nozzle off. Be careful not to bend the auger. And here's the auger on the inside. Pretty cool, right? The auger and these five mixing blades are attached to a shaft. And on that shaft in the motor housing is this hub or gear looking thing. And with the help of a chain, the hub is attached to a small motor at the back of the Pugmill. A Pugmill has two settings besides off. Pug spins it forward and forces clay out. Mix spins backwards to mix clay inside the chamber. Here's a better shot of the mixing blades. I use a large trimming tool and a rubber rib to remove all the clay from each part of the nozzle. Clean this well, especially if you're going to a lighter clay, otherwise you risk contaminating the new clay. There's a lot left over, find a way to use it. One pro tip is to leave a blow dryer to dry the inside of the chamber as you clean the nozzle. I do this because brittle clay is much easier to sponge away than soft, sticky clay. It makes the process much faster. I actually tried throwing in wet sponges and pushing the pug button to see if it would work. It did okay, but it was more fun just to watch, I think. From here on out, it's just a bunch of hard work and elbow grease to get this Pugmill as clean and spotless as you can. Any dark clay left over can leave brown streaks through your newer, lighter clay. It's not worth it. When it's time to reattach the nozzle, be gentle not to bump the auger or bend the auger. Leave all the nuts and bolts loose until they all fit. Finish it up with the ratchet and the wrench. And while you're at it, wipe down the outside, just cuz. And take a picture, because it'll never be this clean again, I promise you. To give you an idea of how I use this, I can use wet clay from the wheel and drier clay from an unused slab vessel, throw it into the mixing chamber, push the mix button, maybe add a little bit of water, but then all the clay is the same consistency when I push the pug button. You should still wedge this though, unless you have a de-airing pugger.
As you can see, this Pugmill is super awesome, super amazing, super old actually, but I'm very lucky to have it in the studio here. If you want some more tutorials or some time-lapse creation videos, check out these over here. And as always, I'm Jim, and whenever possible, be sure to make, do, and learn.